He's very brave, isn't he? I'm ready to die for you. Don't worry about me, I'm fine. I'm sure he's glad to be prayed for. 36, he said to them, but now, whoever has a money belt is to take it along. Likewise, also a bag. And whoever has no sword is to sell his coat and buy one. People divide on this point. They say, there you go, Jesus is in favor of violence. And I want to tell you, this is not what this passage says, as you read on. Some of them didn't have swords, by the way, it's interesting. So they weren't all armed, they weren't all, you know, NRA people. Give me my rights. He does then correct them, because read 37 carefully. This is the explanation. And the word for is very important in Greek. It means, this is what I mean. This is, let me unpack the earlier statement. This is what I'm intending to tell you about why you should buy a sword on this occasion. What is written about me has to be fulfilled. That's a prophecy. That's the point. There's a prophecy in the Old Testament that says, I'm going to be treated as a common criminal. You got it? That's why I have to have a sword. That is obviously fulfilled. He didn't have a sword. You go out and get the swords. Then that prophecy can say, he's just a common criminal. Just like everybody else. It isn't necessarily a justification of being part of a huge war machine. I mean, that would be a bit of a stretch. In your margin, you're going to read, you're going to perhaps please mark Matthew 26:52, where he makes a statement about swords, which is rather more all-embracing particularly. Jesus said to him, this is where Peter took up the defensive sword. Oh, come on now. I'm going to chop the ear off. I'm going to defend my master against this invasion of the sword in that passage in Matthew 26. This is 51. Let me read it. Behold, one of those who were with Jesus reached and drew out his sword. So they did have some swords. That's true. And struck the slave, the high priest, and cut off his ear. Now Jesus replied to this use of the defensive sword, may I point out here. Put your sword back into its place, for all those who take up the sword will perish by the sword. That's rather sweeping. So it's, you know, a subject to be thinking about. But the earlier one in Luke is very clear. The reason for that sword, if you haven't got a sword, is that there's a text which says that he's going to be treated as a common criminal. And when they got over that, he says, if you read down in 37, 38, he was numbered with transgressors. Well, that which refers to me will have its fulfillment on the basis of getting the swords. They said, here we are, Lord, two swords. He said, it's enough. We got the point. See, it's a very subtle. Two is enough for the fulfillment of the prophecy. That's what it is. That's the explanation. Why get the sword? Because there's a prophecy which says that he will be reckoned as a common criminal. That couldn't happen until they had the sword. Then he says, it's enough. Two swords. Here are two swords. Nah, that's it. I have only made this point, which I did at Bethany in my training there. I wrote the paper on should Christians kill each other. Oh, you can talk about coming into the house. I know that's rare and that can happen. You have your sword to defend yourself. That's more unlikely. But think about international warfare, where Christians have always killed each other, and pause before you are going to drop the bomb on another Christian. My wider point, though, when I was at school there, getting that degree, was it's unconscionable for me to think of Christians killing each other. So the local thing is trickier. However, when the Roman Catholic blessed the Roman Catholic priest, the bomb that killed the nuns changed his life. Because Jesus said, by this you will be recognized as benign disciples. You have loved one for another. You cannot be thinking of killing other Christians. Now think of this, please. The clergy are not permitted to bear arms. What are we saying there? Why do we say, I don't want to arm the Methodists here in America to go and kill the Methodists in Germany. What are we saying? We're saying, heaven forbid. But I'm saying, take that one stage further. Just as bad for the clergy as it is for anybody else.